Hello, I'm Alex and this is Libre Graphics World. I was kind of hoping that the game team would be wrapping up development for a new release in late May 2020. This has been no new features and mostly polished by now. Well, tough luck. There are 2 new filters and 1 major filter update. There are even more changes coming, but that's another story. Please note that in this video I am intentionally leaving out some technical details, because these changes deserve a vastly more verbose explanation. And right now I just want to quickly show some exciting new stuff. So first off, the Vignette filter now has on-canvas controls to simplify tweaking the effect settings. Rather than changing numeric values in the dialog, you can now drag the controls right on the canvas to adjust the radius and softness of the vignette, scale it, reposition the center, and so on. It also has new vertical and horizontal shapes, to which I will get back in a minute. The next change is a new filter called Focus Blur, which, as you can see, shares the on-canvas user interface with the vignette filter. So you can easily set the area of the image that would stay in focus and adjust the falloff for blurring everything else. Focus Blur usually has 2 popular applications. The first one that you can see here is simply blurring everything that you want to be out of focus. So you can open a picture taken with your phone and make it look sort of like you shot it on a digital camera with aperture wide open to get a very shallow depth of field. The second one is creating a tilt shift fake, which is basically an imitation of using a real tilt shift lens or a regular wide angle lens with a tilt shift adapter. What this photography gear does is essentially modifying the plane of focus and changing the perceived depth of field. The shift part of the real gear is commonly used in architecture photography. One of its use cases is to make straight lines out of camera without further perspective correction in software. But the tilt part is where all the fun begins, because tilting the plane of focus results in modified depth of field. And when you shoot with the camera pointing downwards from a high place, tilting the plane of focus can make real objects look like toys. It's a kind of a cheesy use case, but it's a lot of fun. So that's why the new filter has horizontal and vertical shapes that I previously mentioned. Now, in my personal opinion, there are ups and downs to using the Focus Blur filter. It does make pretty pictures, there is no doubt about it. But if you want a realistic imitation, you need a more versatile tool. Which brings us to the third change, that is the new Variable Blur filter. It's pretty much the under-the-hood engine that drives the fancy-pants Focus Blur filter. Basically, you can draw your own mask to mark parts of an image to be blurred at variable intensity. Using mask for that is actually a very simplistic approach. So Al, who developed all these new features, is likely to make this filter use a depth map instead. This will help getting a more realistic rendering. So I will get back to this with great many more details when the next version is out, which I hope is still going to happen within the next few weeks. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel if you want to stay tuned to new features in free software for creative professionals. See you soon.